Hello, welcome to another vlog about building Indymill. A little bit different this time as I'm filming myself. I got a new job, so I ordered the last parts and are waiting for them to come. So there's a little changes, there's a little thing happening. But I want to show one thing. Someone on the Indymill Facebook group, I think it was, found this one, which is a screw for flipping the nut on the ball screws over. The original one, the original one is just a pipe. It's linked in, well, it's not linked, but Nicodem talks about it. I never used it, so I have no idea if it worked, but someone says use this instead so you can screw it in and retain the balls better. And I think he was right, because I have done this 3 times required to build this, and on 2 occasions I have lost some of the balls. It still works, and I could order some more and put it in, but I haven't yet. But if you put this one, print it good quality and sandpaper, really make it sweet. And then when you have that, line it up, focus somewhere here. Yeah, come on. Ooh. So you put it in and then line up so the ball goes over, and then there's no problem, and then it works. The first 2 times I also used this, but I hadn't cleaned it with sandpaper and made it nice, and I haven't, I just maybe was a little bit so good advice. Print this one, I'll link it in this video description, and print it good, and then it's easy, really easy. I have no idea if this one works. Ironically, it's a totally clean print. It's so smooth that it probably works. You can see reflection here. So let me show you what I've got, and I'll do it in this view because otherwise I have to edit the video, and I don't do that. This is a vlog, it's the story. So, not much has happened. I put in this, and it runs good. I have put the extra ones down here. I have, I can't see if I can, film the right place. I have printed, I have no idea what you can see. This one, the back plate here. Also, I'll link the description. The thing is, on the Y axis, you have like a normal bearing, and then you have a press bearing, and then you put the is it M12 nut on the ball screw, and then keep it together. But it can just slide there. There should be a cap on that Y carriage thing. Well, not carriage, what's it called? Yeah, wire carriage, that, one here. Can you see it? Yeah, this one. So this one new, also one here. So on this, you keep it together and then the screw on the outside. So, yeah. And that works. That really works. So I can only recommend that. Yeah. So it's coming along. I have to build the gate for this. No, this gate. It's called the door here. And I'm thinking about putting it up here and then having it like this and then up. So I can just flip it up and maybe hang it on the ceiling because it's low. Or maybe just over here on the door. I'm figuring that one out. Got my 3D printer. Sorry, I think I got that one too. Also. Oh, yeah, yeah. Let's see if we can see anything down here. We can. Well, in there, there is my vacuum cleaner. I have to maybe get to it. Again. And the cyclone I got. I was really worried that the vacuum cleaner I got, which is because of EU regulation, is not that powerful. The Americans, they use like 2, 3, or 5 horsepower engines. And here in the Eurozone, we don't, I think we can get maybe, we use another system to measure, but it's like maybe 1, 1.5 horsepower, if that. But even though I thought it was maybe a little not too good or not powerful enough, it really is. It can, even from that long hose there, it can suck down and in the cyclone and all that. It really works. I was thinking, this is never gonna work. But before the system is really put together, it's hard to really understand the, there's something about it. So, yeah. Also, organization, jobs to do, whiteboard markers. So, yeah. That's really it. That's really much. I'm beginning wiring soon. Maybe I'll show you that. I have, there we go. I've bought these to, it's like a switch, a box to keep cables in. And I'm gonna crimp it with the same, these crimpers here. I just waiting for the pliers and more. And then I'm putting this on the stemmer also, so I can have short wires in here, and then I can wire the long wires in here, because I have built two before, and I try to measure, but sometimes it's like, you have to turn this wires around, because then it goes the other way, and blah, blah, blah. So I thought it was just easier, and they're dirt cheap. I can throw a link in the description of these also. I think it's like, it was Banggood or Alibaba or something like that. So, yeah, it's a pack of tin for not nothing, but more change. So, yeah. What else? That cable chain. I saw someone do some brackets you could print to put this on. And I'm gonna try that. So, yeah. I took all of 2 meters of it. I hope that's enough. There's wiring. Wiring is expensive in Denmark. I have no idea why. White wires all around. But I'm probably gonna color code it so I don't mess up. That's it. The building is going very slow because, new job, I have to prioritize. It's a great job. It's in, fun enough, it's on a shop that builds machines. And I'm like a technical guy on a computer. I'm an engineer, but this mechanical designer is more correct. But the shop has like a Haas UMC 750. 5-axis CNC, and they have like CNC lathes and all that, and Grizzlies or Petersons is called in Denmark. Yeah, it's a Danish version. Like also CNC, I can't remember what it's called. So all the things I find really interesting, I'm just surrounded by a job. And I'm getting to know my colleagues, and I actually now can get them to do stuff for me. Like, I have a pretty well-equipped workshop in the back end now. But also, I can learn from the experience in running CNCs and actually come to work and say, hey, this part, blah, 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 maybe you have an idea, so on and so on. So that's pretty cool. So, yeah. Organization for wires. It's just like small stuff like that. Hey, and I finally found a gunner to lubricate with. So, yeah. Well, I'm gonna end it here. If you have any questions, then ask away. Just show you my little eye trick here. Yeah. Bye.